Now, actually, all this thing which I have spoken is very good in theory. This is very good in theory, but it is very difficult to exhibit. What is the reason? What is the reason? The reason is how our human brain has developed. That we need to understand. So we are having three brain, right? One is reptilian complex, which is ancestral brain, right? Which we have derived from our ancestor. So our ancestor means our parent, our grandparent, our forefathers, and that monkey from which the human race has been, the Homo sapiens, first Homo sapiens came into existence, the Australopithecus and that monkey. And before monkey, there were snakes and there are reptiles. So the reptilian, earlier in the world, there is only reptilians. And reptilian do not have any feelings. They are having only two behaviors, flight and fight, right? They have only one survival instinct. I have to eat, I have to born, I have to eat, I have to produce, and I have to die. These are the only things they know. Like just like a snake, either he fight, either he attack, or he try to survive from the opponent's attack, right? Then after the reptilian, the mammal great brain develops. So the animal with the four legs, right? They are having operating analysis, right? They know how to operate. So they are having operating efficiency. So they develop operating efficiency. So which is limbic brain. And then the neocortex, the reasoning, the analytical brain develop, which is called human brain, right? So only the upper portion is a human brain. All the other two are the reptilian brain. These are the animal brain that we still have in our brain. Because see, and this has been, these are there from crores of years, right? These brains, and there we store the permanent memories. What is our permanent memory? When a child born, take birth, right? When a child take birth, do you have to train them how to breathe? No, he knows it how to breathe because it is there in the reptilian brain. Some of our reaction, for example, you are standing below a building and something is falling from that building of the 10th story and it is falling on your head. What you will do, right? You will automatically, you will step away from that spot, right? And for that, your reptilian brain only functions, which is called your survival brain. It keep you alive, right? And survival brain is always powerful. It take over everything, right? And that is what one need to understand. So it take control. Whenever there is a danger, it will take control of the rest of the brain. So three types of brain: reptilian brain, instinct, dominance, and survival. Then mammal brain, feelings and emotions. Then human brain, language, ideas, concept, artists, visions, right? So this respond, human brain respond, the reptilian brain is react, right? Reacting to the situation. For example, what is the reaction and what is the response? For example, you are getting into train and somebody push you from behind. What will you do? You will force, you will get angry and you are about to slap him, right? Because that is where the reptilian brain come into function. If somebody give you a big push, your reaction is to turn back and give him a slap. But eventually you realize that he is your old friend, right? The moment you see your old friend, your human brain start working. And it react, oh, he is my friend. He don't want, he must have not done it intentionally. It may be by mistake and you won't think. So now the signal goes to your human brain. But for example, if the earlier case which I have discussed, when some object is falling onto you from the 10th story, can you use your human brain at that time? So human brain to do analysis. Oh, it has reached to the 7th floor. Let it reach to 3rd floor, then I will step down. And if it is not heavy, why should I move at all? If you start analyzing thing and you start using human brain, you will be dead if the thing is heavier than your expectation. So first thing, the reptilian brain moves you away from that spot. Then you see what has dropped. Then you analyze. Okay, I took a great decision by moving. But actually you have not taken the decision. Your reptilian brain has already took the decision. At that time, your survival brain doesn't function. Your human brain doesn't function. Only your survival brain functions. And that is how the brain works. Now, we as a human beings are basically pessimist for people, because our reptilian brain is pessimist. It is not optimist. Believe me, 80% people are pessimist. They are not optimist. What happens to a brain in fear? Fear activates the amygdala. Amygdala is nothing but your reptilian brain, which makes people more receptive to the misinformation, right? During COVID, one of my friends tell me, okay, in graveyards, there are lots of lost dead body lying everywhere. Now this information is actually misinformation. Nobody has checked it. Never it has got repeated. It is just a grave find. But this misinformation are generally processed very carefully during the time of crisis, because you generally do not look at this information in the good time, right? Your reception to that information become very active during the time of crisis. So fear activates amygdala, which makes people more receptive to the misinformation. So if you are not reading newspaper, you are uninformed. And if you are reading them, you are misinformed, because the first page of any newspaper is negative, because for negative news, your reception, your attention level is 5 times more than the positive news. So try with your spouse, be it your wife or be with your husband. Tell him, give him an instruction, a general instruction. Both of them can neglect it or cannot listen it properly. They just hear them. They don't listen them, right? There is a lot of difference between hearing and listening. Before making anything, tell him that I will tell you something. So I tried it with my wife. So I will tell you something. You don't tell it to anyone else. The moment I say this sentence, the attention span increases, because whenever this line is told, it is mostly the following information has to be negative, right? So attention span increases the moment you start with negative news. And then I say to my wife, please pay this bill, today is the last date. Actually, you know, why you told that you don't tell it to anyone? Because I wanted to increase your attention span, right? So that is what the negative brain is very powerful. And human beings are born pessimist. Why? Because again, the answer is in reptilian brain. So during our ancestral age, during the age when the human was not in the cities, they were into the jungle and relying on the hunt, the hunts, right? They go for a hunt for their meal. So how these people, so when you are going for a hunting in the jungle, in a forest, there is chances that you may also get hunted by the animal. So if you are pessimist, right, you will remain more alert. And being a pessimist is advantageous at that time. And that's why our reptilian brain is pessimist, because it is a permanent memory. It will take thousands of years to change. That memory will take thousands of years to change, right? And that is what is the problem. And so that reptilian brain, the pessimism is still into our brain. And that's why we react to negative information very fast, because it is our natural behavior. And to modify that behavior, you have to train your human brain. Your human brain has to control, need to learn how to control your reptilian brain. For example, many of us would try to reduce our tummy fat. How many of us are successful? For example, why our tummy get bigger and bigger with the age? The reason is when that Australopithecus, right, was doing and going for any hunt, whenever he get any animal for his meal, he eat everything he can eat, right? Whether his tummy is full or not, he kept on eating it, because he don't know when he will get his next meal. That's why he was very desperate for food, and whatever he can eat, he eat everything, despite of what kind of hunger he is having. Now, so that is there in the reptilian brain. But today, if you see, the condition is not like that. We don't have any problem of food. Food is available plenty, but still the reptilian brain is still there. It takes us. So if you are not hungry and you will be shoved a snacks plate beside you, you are not hungry, you automatically start eating it. Right? Because the reptilian brain, the food is here, eat. If you are doing nothing, you automatically get hungry and you start eating. I think many of you have the observation. So those who are on the diet, they have to control their reptilian brain with that human brain. So you don't require any further calorie. You are having enough calorie. You don't need to eat that. You have to control it, continuously practice that. So that's why it is very difficult to control a reptilian brain during a crisis. Most of the reptilian brain become active and they don't allow you to buy equities at that point of time. So that is the single simple reason why people don't invest. So how our brain function? For example, what is the belief about stock market in your brain, in your reptilian brain? Because what your father would have taught, do not invest into stock market. It is gambling. Stay away from it. Your first father has also teach him the same thing, right? So the belief about the stock market is very negative in our reptilian brain. So if the belief is negative, whenever the market fall, if against belief you have invested first, right? That is against belief of your reptilian brain, you have invested first at the first place. Then the market fall. So whenever the market fall, it reminds you your tell of your grandfather or your father that he has told you to stay away from it. So your action during the fall would be negative. If your action is negative, you are not investing or you are pulling out at that point of time. Your action is negative, the result would be negative. And if the result is negative, now you are having evidence of that belief. And that belief will get stronger that stock market is gambling, right? First, develop a belief that stock market is not gambling. Stock market is the most, to make money in the stock market, you don't require intelligence, you require spiritual ability to control your brain. Because all those Rishi Munis, right, where you can see the aura around them, have developed a behavior to control that reptilian brain through that human brain. And that's why that aura you can see in any mythological program, right? So first, belief has to be very strong in whatever you are doing. If your belief is weak, you will never make money. So plus understand the market. Market require a strong belief about wherever you are doing. If your belief is positive, your action would be positive. The result would be positive and the evidence. Now you are evidence that you can make money from this market and your belief will get stronger and stronger, right? So this is what, how, this is why I told you how we need to control our brain and make the investment decision.